Hello friends! In this chapter, we are going to see some properties and curiosities about prime numbers. Since Euclid proved that there are infinitely many primes, they have a lot to offer. There are infinitely many prime numbers. Euclid proved this. There are always more primes. No matter how high up we go into the natural numbers, there will always be more primes. They never end. The power of mathematical tools is amazing. We know with certainty that there are prime numbers in remote borders that we will never explore. Neither us nor anyone else in the future. And now, what do we see? Well, now we are assailed by many doubts, which I will illustrate. Let us tackle them. What happens with the distribution of prime numbers among natural numbers? This will be discussed in detail in a later chapter, because it's one of the fundamental elements of this collection of videos. But it is now interesting to introduce some oddities. Ever since man knows how to calculate, at first with a pen and a paper, and already in the 20th and 21st centuries with computers, the healthy sport of hunting prime numbers has existed. There have always been people who, through imaginative procedures, have rivaled to obtain the largest list of prime numbers, or the largest non-prime number. That is, in this area there are two battlefields, that of those seeking the largest prime number of all, regardless of which there may be before, and that of those who seek the largest list of consecutive primes. Since there is no known practical formula to tell if a number is a prime, or to generate all prime numbers, calculations must be made in the manner of the sieve of Eratosthenes. Not exactly, as we have already said that such a method is not speed efficient. Other faster methods are used, although they are mathematically very complex. There are formulas that generate some prime numbers, but here is not useful a magic formula that generates all primes and only primes. Euclid already proved that the existing number of primes is infinite, so the task of searching them will never end. Is it important to know large prime numbers? Yes, it is, as many encryption methods and other scientific applications are based on this. The largest known prime number. Let us look at the very summarized history of the largest known prime number. By 1588, Pietro Cataldi had verified that the number 2 raised to the power of 17 minus 1, that is 131,071, was a prime number. He also verified that 2 raised to the power of 19 minus 1, that is 524,287, was also a prime number. These numbers have 6 digits. Cataldi, like many others, thought that in most cases, number 2 raised to the power of n minus 1, when n was a prime number, was also a prime, and this is because up to 2 raised to 13 minus 1, the formula gives mostly prime numbers as result. Let us see. Prime, 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 non-prime, prime. Later, in year 1640, Pierre de Fermat worked with the case of n equal to 23, showing that the result was not a prime number. Leonhard Euler searched and proved that in the case of n equal to 29, no prime number was obtained either. However, in 1772, Euler himself verified that in the case of n equal to 31, a prime number was obtained. In 1867, Landry found a large prime number, 2 raised to the power of 59 minus 1 over 179,951 with 13 digits. And in 1876, Lucas verified that the number 2 raised to the power of 127 minus 1 with 39 digits was also a prime number. Until 1951, no greater prime number was found. Fourier was to find the next already huge 44-digit number. Until Fourier, no computers had been used. That is, calculations were done by hand, or at best in the 20th century, with mechanical calculators. Of course, the sieve of Eratosthenes method was not used, but other based on theorems of Fermat and Euler, or later of Lucas, Lehmer, and many others, which speeded up calculations. Since then, the use of computers caused an avalanche of increasingly large primes. Note that we are not talking about lists of primes up to a given maximum, but of the largest prime number known at all times. To have good information about the history of calculation of prime numbers and other interesting aspects, I recommend you study the website of Professor Chris Caldwell at the University of Tennessee at Martin. It is a very well-documented web. On the date of edition of this video, May of 2018, the largest known prime number is... This prime number, calculated by Pace, Waldman, Kurowski, Blosser, and Gims, is known since December 26, 2017. GIMS is the acronym for Great Internet Mersenne Prime Search, a collaborative project of thousands of volunteers who use freely available software on their computers to discover new very large primes. This mega prime number has 23,249,425 digits. On one of the fullest pages of a common book, there are about 2,500 characters. This means that if we printed this number, apart from the environmental crime committed in electricity consumption, ink and paper, we will use 9,300 pages, the equivalent of almost 1 meter thick book. To get an idea of the magnitude of this number, it will suffice to know that the universe is estimated to have around 10 to the power of 80 atoms of matter. This is only a 1 followed by 80 zeros, that is, 81 digits. Less than pocket money compared with a super special non-prime number with over 23 million digits.
So what? What does this mean? Well, it is not really important, but if we think that this number is a prime because has no divisors, none, then it might make us think a little. Of all the possible ways there are for a number to have divisors, and such a large number even more so, actually it does not. It has no divisors. Are there larger prime numbers? Yes, there are infinitely many largest prime numbers. Euclid's theorem says so. Prime numbers hunters, even knowing that their task is endless, engage seriously in finding the next largest known prime. And this is not just for the sake of finding it, but also because of the great technological device that is needed to carry it out. Very powerful computers in some cases, or clusters of thousands of small computers in other cases. We leave things here for the moment. In the next chapter, we will see what the twin primes number are and the conjecture they gave rise to. We will also see that there may be deserts of prime numbers between natural numbers. And finally, we will know another one of the problems about prime numbers of very simple enunciation, but nevertheless without solution until today. The Goldbach conjecture. Thank you for watching.